Scientists reveal the dramatic impact that eating oatmeal every day has on your body. These days, everybody loves oatmeal. That's not just our opinion either. It's a certifiable fact. Don't believe us? Well, according to Zion Market Research, in 2016, the international oatmeal industry was worth an approximately $2 billion and will be valued at $2.5 billion in 2022. Part of the reason for this, the experts argue, is people's current desire for healthy living. And when we think of oatmeal, we seemingly automatically equate it with good nutrition. But is this delicious breakfast staple really that great for you? It certainly seems that the question is worth consideration, particularly as consumers in the US are buying oats in droves. In fact, data released via Information Resources Incorporated stated that Americans spent over $1.3 billion on oatmeal or hot cereal over the course of 2018. That figure also represents a 1.3% increase from the previous year, and that's almost double the amount spent two decades ago. Yet anybody who's traveled the aisles of grocery stores knows that there are a number of different oatmeal varieties available. The most common names you'll likely see in your local shop are oat groats, rolled oats, steel-cut oats, instant oats, and Scottish oats. And perhaps unsurprisingly, each type serves a different purpose. But don't worry too much about the names. After all, each variety is derived from the same basic hulled oats. So why the different types? Well, it actually comes down to how the grain has been processed. The various health benefits or side effects will differ, of course, depending on which variety is your preference. It's worth pointing out, though, that all kinds of oats need at least some form of processing. This is because you simply can't consume them as if they were plucked from a farmer's field. And the reason's fairly self-evident. Unprocessed oats are surrounded by tough outer shells. That's why the husks need to be removed prior to eating. Once the shells have been taken away, then, you're left with your oat groats. You can, of course, purchase whole oat groats from the grocery store to make your oatmeal in the morning. There's a chance you won't do that, however, as this variety takes longer to cook and can still maintain a notable fibrous consistency. And that extra cooking time is why other varieties of oats are subject to further processing. Take steel-cut oats, for example. As the name suggests, steel-cut oats have been, you guessed it, sliced into small sizes with a steel instrument. This process obviously makes the grain smaller and therefore easier to turn into oatmeal. Another kind of processing results is rolled oats. These oats are steamed and then squashed until level. The rolled or old-fashioned oats are subsequently left to dry so that they can happily sit in your cupboard for an extended period of time. This process also means that they don't take as long to cook. There are, of course, two other kinds of oats, Scottish and instant. For the former, the oats are simply reduced to meal, and for the latter, you likely won't be surprised to hear that groats are put through a longer steaming and leveling process. In addition, they're potentially even cooked a little so that you can get oatmeal in a flash at home. Yet while the level of understanding is certainly interesting, you shouldn't be put off of any one kind of oats due to the processing that goes into them. After all, no matter which variety you choose, you'll still be consuming whole grains. And on the balance of things, that means the nutritional aspects of the oats are roughly the same. You can also use any of these oats to make your breakfast. Typically, this would involve cooking the oats in milk or water until you get the kind of consistency you like. You can obviously add all sorts of flavors and toppings to your oatmeal, including fruit, yogurt, and nut butters. But we're only concerned with the actual oatmeal here. Let's deal with the good stuff first. After all, in 2018, Professor Shengmin Sang of A&T State University in North Carolina told Time magazine, "Based on existing evidence, eating whole grain oats is definitely good for our health." Specifically, Sang noted that oats can keep diabetes and cholesterol levels in check. But why are oats so good in these particular health areas? That's partly down to beta-glucan fiber, something that the grain has in abundance. Fiber is good for so many things throughout the digestive tract. Minnesota University's Professor Joanne Slavin, an expert in nutrition and food science, confirmed to Time magazine. In fact, oats have significantly more beta-glucan fiber than many other grains, which could explain why they're considered so beneficial for your gut. But how does it work? Well, according to Harvard's The Nutrition Source website, the soluble fiber attracts cholesterol-stuffed bile acids in the guts and helps us to pass them on. This has, of course, led to the consumption of oats being associated with lowering cholesterol levels. The Nutrition Source does state, however, that the evidence to support this is not so clear-cut. That's because while some studies have indeed concluded that eating beta-glucan can decrease cholesterol, others have not declared particularly significant results. Yet, as we've heard, beta-glucan is useful for a number of other reasons. For one thing, it helps to prevent your digestive system from working so quickly. This, in turn, means that the speed with which nutrients are processed by the body is also decreased. Eating oats, therefore, won't provide a quick hit of energy followed by a slump like, say, snacking on a chocolate bar might. This wonderful fiber slows down digestion because it also absorbs water on its way to your gut. This then makes the food you've eaten thicker and more voluminous. And as well as resulting in the slow release of energy, the process can also follow you to feel fuller for longer. It's no doubt for this reason that oatmeal is often suggested as a quick breakfast for those seeking to lose weight. In fact, there's even a quick fix fad out there known as the oatmeal diet. Practitioners are initially encouraged to eat nothing but oatmeal 3 times a day. But such a low-calorie restrictive diet is not actually advised by experts and could even be harmful. In any case, the point is that if oatmeal, as part of a healthy, balanced diet, slows down your digestion, it could leave you feeling more satisfied. This, in turn, makes you less likely to eat unhealthy snacks throughout the day. And that's why the grain can be helpful in controlling waistlines across the world. There are other healthy benefits to consuming oats as well. First and foremost among these is its ability to aid in the fight against diabetes. This could be particularly good news, considering that the CDC announced in 2017 that over 100 million U.S. citizens could currently have diabetes or be pre-diabetic. The CDC also advised that of the 30 million people in the U.S. with diabetes, around 27 million of them suffer with type 2 diabetes. And that particular form of the condition means that the sufferer's body can't cope well with glucose, which is a kind of sugar. So, someone with type 2 diabetes needs to be wary of foods that could quickly increase their blood sugar levels. Of course, some foods with large amounts of sugar are easy to spot. These could include, say, white chocolate, candy, cakes, or desserts. But sufferers may also need to watch out for naturally occurring sugars in dairy, vegetables, and fruit. And then there's also the possibility of having to watch out for carbohydrate-rich foods that have high glycemic loads. What's a glycemic load, you ask? Essentially, it lets you know how fast the portion of carbohydrates in your food will spike your blood sugar levels. So, foods with high glycemic loads will boost your levels very quickly, while foods with low glycemic loads will be more gentle. And this is where oats come in. So, while oats are packed with carbohydrates, steel-cut oats have a relatively low glycemic load. This means that even those suffering from diabetes can likely consume them because the beta-glucan fiber just might stop those spikes in blood glucose levels. The Nutrition Source website, however, advises against eating instant oats. This could be particularly welcome news for those with type 2 diabetes. That's because the condition, which can be extremely serious, can in some cases be reversible through careful diet and workout regimes. It's always worth consulting a medical professional before undertaking any lifestyle changes, mind you. There are a couple of other noteworthy oat-related benefits too. And the first is likely evident for anyone who's been paying attention. That is to say that oats are good for your gut. In fact, the Nutrition Source states that consuming oats regularly will probably help you to poop easier than ever before. This is due to the oats' high fiber content, which is purportedly even better than that found in vegetables or fruit. And what's more, oats' beta-glucans could improve your microbial population of your digestive system, which, believe it or not, is a very good thing. But it's not just the inside of your body that oats can help out. You see, the final benefit we'll discuss here concerns a pair of chemicals found within the oats. These are known as phytoestrogens and phenolic compounds. And while those words seem pretty sciencey and hard to pronounce, they may actually help you to improve the appearance of your skin. Specifically, these plant chemicals may work to decrease organ inflammation that could reoccur due to the conditions such as diabetes. And according to SF Gate, a 2013 study suggested that oats may also fight the signs of aging on the skin. So, as you can see, consuming oats has a wealth of potential health benefits. But are they purely a force for good? Well, as you can probably tell, the evidence is all for a resounding yes to this question. But it's worth bearing in mind that there are a few caveats to the above advice. So, before you head down to the oats aisle of that grocery store, watch on for some sage oatmeal perfection suggestions. Of particular concern to those who are sensitive to gluten is the possibility of the substance contaminating their oats. On their own, the whole grains are, of course, naturally completely free of gluten. But as researcher Ronald Fritz told Time magazine, there's always the chance that they could be befouled with gluten throughout the journey from field to spoon. Fritz clarified, oats can be contaminated with gluten containing kernels of wheat, barley, and rye at the field, during storage, or during transportation. Why should it matter? Well, for the 1% of people suffering from celiac disease, consumption of gluten is very bad news for their guts. But those with gluten sensitivities could also be affected. That's because those with non-celiac sensitivities can still suffer from grievances of the gut immediately after eating gluten. It seems that scientists don't truly understand how this works, but it's clear that it can be uncomfortable for those with the condition. But there's also one other thing to take into consideration when selecting oats. That other consideration is how to prepare your oats prior to consumption. It sounds obvious, but the health benefits outlined previously will all come to nothing if you then pile your oatmeal high with sugars or various other additives. And for the experts, it seems to be the instant oat varieties that are the worst culprits. For instance, The Independent reported a shocking statistic in 2017. It said that a single pot of Quaker Oats So Simple's Golden Syrup Instant Porridge, available in the UK, contained more than 4 teaspoons of added sugar. Unbelievably, that equates to over 50% of an adult's recommended day-to-day quota of sugar intake. As we've seen, too, this increased sugar would certainly not be a good thing for anyone suffering with or predisposed to type 2 diabetes. But being cautious with your choices can combat this easily. For instance, the original flavor of Quaker's Instant Oatmeal range contains no added sugar at all. Another method of keeping your sugar consumption in check is simply preparing your oatmeal at home from scratch. This is normally pretty straightforward and quick, and there's no shortage of oatmeal ideas available online. So here we'll just outline 2 popular ways of making healthy, balanced breakfasts with everyday ingredients. The first is using the instructions on the packet of your chosen sugar-free oats to prepare the oatmeal, usually using milk or water or a combination of the two. And then once the oats are done, you can incorporate healthy extras such as fruit, seeds, or nuts. For rolled oats, this will take about 5 minutes. Steel-cut oats will take longer, and instant oats will be done in no time at all. But if that still sounds like too much work, you can always go down the overnight oats route. This involves simply popping your oats, chosen liquid, and additional extras together in a jar, bowl, or other container the night before you want to eat your oatmeal. Then mix and cover your serving and pop it into the fridge until morning. Just be aware that you can't use instant oats for this method. So, is oatmeal a good breakfast you can eat every day? The short answer is, of course, yes. Whether you choose instant, steel-cut, or rolled, oats offer a myriad of health benefits that are difficult to argue against. The only things to be wary of are gluten contamination and added sugar.